that know the word. Young men, you have fought the battle. Now every temptation that's going to come your way, evil thoughts are going to come your way in your mind. Perhaps you have already been faced with that. Illicit affairs, immoral practices, drugs, drunkenness, these things are attacking our young men in the church. Don't be caught up in pride and arrogance, hate and anger. How does one overcome? How does one overcome? Scripture says, John says, John implies here that you have faithfully walked with God. You have overcome. You have faithfully done what the Lord asked you to do. You followed His instructions. That's why you have become strong for a long period of time. But then, if perhaps have not become as strong as you ought to be, how then does one overcome Satan? How do we overcome him? We overcome by drawing near to God, by praying and asking for wisdom. James said, if any among you lack wisdom, let him ask God. Don't ask me, but I can't give it to you. Because God give it to all men liberally and upbraided not, it shall be given him, James 1 and 5. God will not chastise you for asking for wisdom. If you need wisdom, ask God. God knows how to deliver the godly out of temptation, how to reserve the unjust under the day of judgment to be punished. God in 2 Peter 2:9. How do they overcome? They overcome by using God's word, by quoting it over and over in their minds to conquer the temptation. Whenever we are tempted to sin, we need to be as Jesus did. Jesus said unto Satan, get behind me, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Luke chapter 4 and verse 8. Jesus was able to tell Satan, you shall not tempt the Lord thy God. We ought to be able to quote the word of God. I know when we came along, when I came along, we were instructed, we were drilled in learning how to quote all of the scriptures concerning the Lord's Supper, quote whole chapters in the Bible. We ought to be able to do that. We need to be able to quote scripture. Why? Because many times we may not have a Bible available. Young men, he instructs young men to be able to do it because their minds are stable. Their minds are stretched. Brother Hammond. They're able to keep things in their memory. I can't quote chapters like I used to. I can't quote them like I used to. But I can quote some of them. But we need to be able to quote full chapters. Recall, be able to relate some Old Testament scriptures with New Testament scriptures to prove our point, because we are going to be attacked. Jesus was able to do that. We need to be able to overcome sin by learning and knowing that God allows temptation to teach us endurance. He allows us to go through temptation, but certainly wants us to be able to withstand. He said, my brethren, James said, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. The trying of your, don't be surprised or disappointed because you are tempted. Don't be disappointed in that. Because he said, this is the trial of your faith. Trial of your endurance. See if you're able to endure. Or are you able to stand your temptation? You're able to overcome by not yielding to their bodies to sin. Paul said, neither yield your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness unto God. Romans chapter 6 and verse 13. They overcome Satan by clothing themselves with the armor of God. Clothing themselves with the armor of God. Ephesians 6, 13 says, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the day of judgment, in the evil day, having done all to stand. Take on the whole armor of God. The helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit. All of these things. Didn't be able to walk with God. He's talking about the word of God. Take it on. They overcome by being on guard and watching for the tempter's temptation. The church needs strong men to watch out for Satan. Because Satan is attacking the church. He's attacking his members. And young men, old men, young women, old women, if you're not strong in God's word, you won't be able to ward off Satan. You won't be able to do it. John said, I'm writing to you. I'm writing to you twice. He's pleading. He's instructing the church. Emphasize. Don't forget where you came from. He said, be sober. Be vigilant. Because you have to serve the devil as a roaring lion walking about seeking whom he may devour. 1 Peter 5 and 8. You therefore, beloved, see. You know these things before. Beware lest you also, being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness. Be well aware of that. 2 Peter 3, 1 to 7. They overcome by not giving into anger, nor giving place to the devil. We overcome Satan. Be angry and sin not. Don't let the sun go down on your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Ephesians 4, 26 and 27. They overcome by submitting to God and resisting the devil. They overcome by not giving in to the enticement of sinners. You know, sinners, they love to entice Christians. They love to entice Christians because they say, well, you're not as strong as you think you are. You're not the person that you proclaim to be. So here is something that you can get involved in. You can make a lot of money. You can make a lot of money. You know, that's the one thing that Satan uses frequently. Let us have a little disaster, a little downfall. Satan comes with all kinds of little tricks, little things, and say, this is what you can do. Overcome. My son, he said, if sinners entice thee, consent not with him. Proverbs 1 and 10. They overcome by not entering into the path of the wicked. Enticing one to use through the use of drugs, alcohol, beverages, gambling, becoming members of gangs, becoming involved in theft rings. We've been walking just a few days ago. My wife was looking for a certain type of makeup. And they said that they can't carry it anymore because every time they get it, the thieves come through. There's gangs. They rob the store, from store to store, where they can go out and sell it. Bank of America told me that they had the same problem. People robbing the store. People implant, they plant people in the bank. And as a ring, they were stealing the money. There's a whole group of folks. And that's happening all over. And Christians, we are not to get caught up in this, in the selling of drugs, young men. Because you're going to get caught. And you get caught, you're going to go to jail. Now your reputation is ruined. You have a long time trying to straighten that out. Don't be caught up in this. Enter not in the path of the wicked, and go not in the way of evil men. Proverbs 4:14. Solomon warned his son, be very careful. Don't enter into the path of the wicked. Don't even go that way. Don't get caught up, because you're going to fall. Remember your great relationship with God over and over again. Emphasis is placed upon this. The stress is upon our relationship with God and His Word. What John has written, it has been written to stir up our relationship to the Father. No matter what our stage of spiritual growth is, we must never forget who it is that we know that is God, who is our Father. We must always remember that we have been blessed to become a son and a daughter of our Father. We must always remember that we have received this great privilege to call God our Father. When we take note of what he said, to the young and to the old, we must always remember the truth of God's word. We must always focus upon God as our Father. We must not let this thought slip from our mind. We must come to God day by day. If we need anything, let us bring our needs to the Father. Let us trust Him that He will look after our needs. Let us trust Him to discipline us when we need discipline. We must study Him, study His Word, and listen to His instruction. That's what He has said to us. Let us always remember to fellowship and commune with God day by day. Let us love Him and receive His love. This is all John was saying. Let us love one another. Let us love God. And let us receive His love that He has given to us. Let us do nothing that would shame Him. Let us share with others what a wonderful Father He is. Fathers, our spiritual fathers, you have been blessed with the deep and rich knowledge of God. Let us remember that you have known God from this one beginning. We must remember everything that has been said about God. But in addition, let us never be lifted up with pride. No matter how long they have walked with God, let us look at these words that He said, you have known Him from the beginning. God has been around from the beginning of time. Much longer than any of us. who are in the faith. No matter how deep and how rich our knowledge is of God, there is so much more to know. It's a sad thing when a person feels that they have known all there is to know about God. They don't need to know anymore. Brethren, when you have been called into come to the training, we have been called to come to the Bible classes, to receive instruction from God. Just remember, you have not arrived. You don't know everything. You need to be instructed. Keep on being instructed in God's word. There is so much more to know. God is eternal. He has an eternity of spirit, experience for us to learn about. We don't know it all. We never will know it all. But we must keep on learning. Keep on receiving instruction. Our lives, our success in life, will depend upon the instruction that we receive from God. How we follow our instructions. Our success will depend upon that. We must never be lifted up in pride as though we know God and have arrived. There is still an eternity of things to learn about God. We must remember where we came from. We must continue to grow and grow in our relationship with God. When we stop growing in our relationship with God, the church stops growing. Then remember that, brother and sister. When we stop growing in our relationship with God, when we stop studying, when we stop communing with God, we are not in prayer with Him, the church begins to suffer. Young men, there's a final instruction that I want to give. A time to be. Young men, there are truths to be kept in mind. There are truths that be kept in mind. There are three things that we need to remember. We must remember, the scripture says, young men, I write to you because you are strong. Why do you think the military, they don't want old men in their army unless they're instructors? Young men are to carry the load. They're to fight the battle because they're strong. God wants young men in His army who are strong, who are able to withstand Satan. Three things. We must know our strength and be assured and have confidence in our strength that we have gained in the Lord. Young men, we must remember that the word of God is to abide in them. This is the key to spiritual growth and pleasing and securing the approval of God. No matter what you think, no matter how you say it, there is no spiritual growth apart from God's word. Shall I repeat that again? There is no spiritual growth apart from God's word. Amen. Young men, there are truths to be kept in your mind. The idea of a clean life. Young men, wherefore shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereunto according to God's word. Psalms 119 and 119 and verse 9. There is a certainty, there is a day of reckoning. Keep this in mind. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. And walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eye. But know this, young man, that for all these things, God will bring you into judgment. The value of restraining one's life. Lamentations 3:27 says, it is good for a man that he bear the yoke in his youth. In other words, it's better to carry the burdens while we're young than to carry them when we're old. Let no man despise your youth, young man, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. 1 Timothy 4:12, Paul's instruction to Timothy. Young men, be an example. Young men are to be sober-minded. In all things, show themselves a pattern of good works. In doctrine, showing uncorruptness, gravity, sincerity, moral strength. Remember this, is mightier than physical strength. Proverbs 30:29, the glory of young men is their strength. I write to you, young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. I write to you, little children, because you have known the Father. I have written to you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you. John said, this is what we ought to remember. Remember that the word of Christ dwelleth richly in all wisdom, teaching, and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Colossians 3:16. This is to all the church. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2:15, Paul's instructions to Timothy. Let the word of God